Welcome. Thank you for coming out for the Relay of Life of Wakefield and joining the American Cancer Society to create a world free from the pain and suffering caused by cancer. My name is Elaine Silva, and I am your event lead and your MC for the 19th Relay for Life here in Wakefield. When we raise money through the Relay of Life, we help the American Cancer Society touch the lives of so many, those who are currently battling cancer, those who may face the diagnosis in the future, and those who may avoid a diagnosis. Today, we are here to celebrate all those who have battled cancer, our survivors in the purple t-shirts, our loved ones lost, and take action to save lives. Over the next 15 hours, our event will recognize the battle around the clock by those facing cancer. The light and the darkness of the day and the night parallel, the physical effects, emotions, and mental state of a cancer patient while undergoing treatment. I'd like to introduce to you Anna Saccarelli, one of our American Cancer staff partners.
Hi, everyone. So I won't talk long. I just want to thank all of you for all you've done for the American Cancer Society's mission for the past 19 years. That's quite a legacy to have here in Wakefield. I have been doing Relay since I was 3 years old, and I have never seen a survivor's tent set up so beautifully, and the weather just so perfect for a Relay for Life. So congratulations on all of your hard work. I look forward to celebrating, remembering, and fighting back alongside you all night tonight. All right, thank you.
Do you want to come in closer or how close? Okay, come on in. Yeah, of course you're going to come over. I'd like to introduce you and thank very much the Harbor Light Show Chorus, who will now sing our national anthem. And next, we will have a welcoming from the town of Wakefield, from our town council, Anthony Longo.
Oh, good evening, everybody. A little bit better weather than we had last year at this time. Thank you from everyone from the town of Wakefield. And yes, I am a cancer survivor, like many of you here tonight. I'm 4.5 years out. In my case, it was advanced. In my case, it was advanced form of metastatic cancer. And to beat this, I went through 39 rounds of chemotherapy, upwards of 2 or 3 a day at some point. One does not go through something like that without great care, determination, and a sense of humor. And tonight, I just want to share some of those moments of levity. My first week of inpatient at Mass General coincided with the open enrollment period for my health insurance. This is the time of year which you make changes to your health insurance for the coming year. I was on the phone with my insurance provider, hooked up to a bag chemo. As we finished up my health, dental, and vision options, next question was, before Mr. Longo, before we finish up, will you be making any changes to your life insurance? And my response was, yes, I think we should increase it. During my second round of inpatient Mass General, I was on the phone with my wife, and again hooked up to a bag chemo. She told me she was planning a family trip for 6 months down the road. And my question to her is like, what are you kidding me? This could go real south quick. And without skipping a beat, my wife responded, relax, you'll be fine. We can take your father. You have the same name. I wish I could make some of this stuff up. I thank you for everything you do for a cure. Your hard work, without that, there could be a different speaker tonight. Again, thank you from the town of Wakefield. Good night.
Thank you, Anthony. He's on his way to his daughter's eighth grade graduation dance. It was nice of him to take the time out. I now would like to bring to the podium our guest speaker. Is Dr. Jamie McKenzie from Leahy Health. Dr. McKenzie is a medical oncologist at Leahy Medical Center and received her medical degree from Drexel University College of Medicine. Dr. McKenzie?
Thank you, and hello everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the Relay for Life tonight. I've had the privilege of helping patients fight cancer for 9 years as an oncologist now, and it's my first Relay for Life, so I'm honored to be here and be speaking. This is truly an amazing event, a gathering of family, friends, neighbors, coworkers, community leaders, all together to help us put an end to cancer. As many of you may know, the Relay for Life was started by one person, a colorectal surgeon named Dr. Klatt in Tacoma, Washington, back in 1985, 33 years ago. He by himself ran around a track much like this for 24 hours, over 83 miles, and in doing so raised $27,000 for cancer research. The next year, 220 people joined him, and I think that's where this all took off. Today, this is held in more than 5,000 communities in 23 countries and has raised $5 billion for cancer research. By walking today, you are joining forces with 3.5 million people just like you who want to save lives. At Leahy Health Cancer Institute, we are working hard to improve the care of patients, taking new and innovative approaches to prevention, diagnosis, and the treatment of cancer. We're among one of the first hospitals in the country to offer free lung cancer screening to high-risk patients about 5 years ago. We are also involved in a risk assessment model into our mammogram centers that identify women who might be at increased risk because of possible family history or genetic mutations. All of our expertise that's available in Burlington is also available at all of our community sites. I work in the Peabody Clinic, but we also have physicians taking care of patients in Beverly, Winchester, and a couple of locations in New Hampshire. So that's a little synopsis of what we do. The Relay for Life starts tonight with the Survivors Lab. There are now 15.5 million cancer survivors in the U.S., and this number is expected to grow to over 20 million in the next 10 years. Even though the new rates of cancer are decreasing in men and staying about the same in women, the numbers of cancer survivors keep growing and growing. So the survivors during this lap are invited to circle the track and celebrate the victories they have achieved and their loved ones and caregivers, all the time, love and support they give as well. In my journey helping patients fight cancer, I have found that the courage, determination, attitude, and spirit that all of my patients and their loved ones bring to this fight is so inspiring. I have more appreciation for life than I've ever known, and a stronger sense of purpose with each patient that I get to take care of. You are all an inspiration to me, so thank you so much. Everyone's reason to participate tonight in the Relay for Life may be different, but here everyone may celebrate, remember, and help fight back. I'm energized to meet people in the community who are equally passionate about defeating cancer as I am. No matter why you take part, it is certain you are helping the American Cancer Society to save lives with every step you take. We at Leahy are extremely grateful to everyone tonight. It will truly make a difference for cancer patients in the country and around the world. So enjoy every step of your walk. Have a wonderful night, and thank you again.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I have a little something for you. A really good dessert. Oh, that's just something. Thank you so much.
Almost put the wrong glasses on. You'd really have to wait a minute. Okay, at this time, there's a little bit of a recognition. I'd like to thank the event leadership team. I think a little bit of a background to let people know. In the past years, we have had at least 14 to 20 people on our event team. Well, this year, we have the amazing 8 who have, I think, deserve a round of applause for making sure this event came on. We have Amy, raise your hand, Lisa, Dorian, Carrie, Claire, and we have Sabrina on her way back from Rome that will be joining us, and Debbie, who's out in California for her daughter's graduation. I thank you. And also a very, very big thank you to Shannon McNamee. She is our, what they call, remote American Cancer Support Manager from Birmingham, Alabama, who has done an amazing job the last 3 months helping us with our event. I would now like to ask Paula Giannocco to light our flame of hope. Paula is a survivor who has been with us for 12
years.
That's all?
Yeah.
She says 12. I think it's longer.
All right.
Okay, let's give it 13. Paula?
I just think she... What's the difference?
I love the outfit. There it is. Hey. It's lit.
Give you a big hug. You are awesome. Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is for you.
Oh, not necessary, but thank you.
Okay. Okay, now we're going to get things started. But before we do, I would like to do just a little quick recognition. This is our 19th year, and we're hoping that we will be back here for the 20th. But tonight in our audience are two of our original founders, and I'd like them to stand, Bog McPhee and Judy Hunt. If you would please stand. Go ahead, stand up, come on. Bob, yeah. They are the people that started this 19 years ago. And I do expect you to be on the committee next year. I already wrote your names down. Okay, let's start to get this. At this time, just a couple of housekeeping rules. Just remember, in the event of inclement weather and we have to evacuate, we will do what we have done in the past. We'll ask you to leave, walk down over the hill, and you'll go into the VOC, okay? And the other thing is about your no campfires. We will have the community fire pits later. Remember, there are restrooms at both ends of the field. We ask that you try to keep your area as clean as possible. There are plenty of activities. There's an activity schedule in the captain's bags. And also, right before the luminaria ceremony, we will ask you to get those lighters and come and give the luminaria committee a hand and light those. Okay, at this time, we would like the survivors and their caregivers to line up here at the arch. And you're going to have a picture taken. We actually have one survivor. I think she's out front. Where is she? Who actually told me today that she got a very good news about her cancer not being there and cured today. She has none. And she, look at her. She got the news. Not even her doctor could believe today's results to tell her. And while they're getting ready, just to let you know, once they start the walk around, I would ask you, I'll call your teams, and if your teams would come out and line the tracks so that we can cheer them on. Okay. Let me see, the first team down to line the track would be Cancer Sucks with their captain, Kerry Hannon. Angels of Hope with Marie Banks, if you would come and line the track. Battle Buddies with Kara Morgan. And Coley's Angels with Pamela Girardi, also one of our former committee members.
I know I saw Pam. Where did she go?
Dedicated to Donna is the Cummins family. And we have the Archangelo Angels with Cheryl Coppola. Hunt for a Cure with Judy Hunt. Jenny's Angels, Rachel McNall. Keys to Cure with Nancy Shavs. Lucky Ladies with Victoria Piscatelli. Mom's Cancer Fighting Ages, Angels with Guy Moley. Olga's Angels with Elaine Silva. Purple Penguins with Caitlin Morgan. Raiders Don't Sleep with Tess Mealy. Our biggest team this year. 74 participants in that team. Under Mr. Mallory, you should wave your hands. Come down and line that track. You'll be the biggest supporting group. Raiders Don't Sleep, Soul Sisters with Matt Boudreau, Tara's Troop with Alexis Christie, Team Hope with Lisa Ventura. Now I believe in the second place for the highest team to raise money. Team Jude for the relay with Judith Terenzano. Where are you, Judy? I didn't even see. Oh, there you are. I see you. Team No Name with Claire Brown. The Rock with Justin Jones. The Wakefield Weekend Warriors, Patricia Murphy. The Warriors Walk with Jane Newbigin. The Wow Factor with Dorianne Dolitsky. And the Saving Bank Lifesavers with Amy Walsh. Do we have the picture?
Do we have a picture? Do we get it? Okay.
Oh, just waiting. Don't forget, we have some really great raffle baskets over there. Year's membership to Planet Fitness in Reading. There's golf baskets, children's games. And we have hot dogs and hamburgers and chips and water, orange juice for sale. And as you walk around the track, you'll notice that a lot of the teams are having fundraisers, some of them having some bake sales. And I got an in on a few of them. They sound really good. And there's popcorn for sale at the movies. Okay, are we ready? Oh, look at those people. Smile. All right. Okay, Tim. We're ready.
Over 15 million people.
All the survivors and caregivers will head to the tent for dinner.